you all so much for joining us today. You're in for a very special treat. Not only are you going to watch the first episode of Chainsaw Man, the English dub version, nonetheless, we're also going to have some exclusive news to share with you at the very end, so you're going to want to stick around. But before then, I'm going to introduce some very special guests onto the stage. They're the English cast for Chainsaw Man. So please first give a warm round of applause to Mike McFarland, the ADR director for the series. Next up, the voice of Denji, Ryan Colt-Reeby. First, we are going to watch the trailer for the English dub of the PV, so let's check it out. Trailer, and it's like hype every single time. So, man, I haven't even seen the first episode yet, so I'm all with you. Like, I'm really excited for this. But before we do watch the episode, we're going to ask our cast members some questions here. So starting off, we're going to go down the line, and starting off with Mike, what was your reaction when you found out you'd be working on Chainsaw Man?
So tight!
I was so excited. I had put in like a request and interest for it, but you never know how those are going to pan out. And I'm someone who like, here's my interest and I will hold it close to my heart and I will not like hope and I have to just let it go if it doesn't happen, but it did, and then I had a little, you know, private cheerleading celebration in my home. So I was so stoked that I'm so excited about this title.
Very nice, very nice. Ryan, what about you?
It started with a text message from Mike, and he was like, hey buddy, you have a minute to talk? And I was like, yeah, of course. So he calls me and he's like, yeah, so I'm gonna be directing Chainsaw Man. And I'm like, oh my God, dude, that's so incredibly cool. Still not processing why he would be telling me this.
Just sharing, like,
exactly. Bye. And he's like, so by the way, you're gonna be our Denji. And I'm like, gasping for air, basically crying, losing my mind. This is a dream role for me.
And especially Ryan, because I know that you're a big fan of manga too.
Yeah, I've read the entire thing 4 times over. Like, disturbing amount.
Very cool. Sarah, how about yourself?
I was like, is this real life? I also got a text from Mike, and I was like, this can only mean one thing. And then I got a call, and I was trying to stay very calm. And then I was like, oh, really? That's amazing. And then after I got on the call, I was like, so yeah, super, super, super hyped.
Very nice. And apologies, Susie.
Yeah.
And how about you then?
I was in the middle of a shift at my day job. I had no idea, I did not think I was going to get this at all. I was like, oh, Mike's gonna call me, great. I'm in Chainsaw Man. I tried to stay as professional as possible during the call, but as soon as that was over, I walked out to my car and I screamed at the top of my lungs. I believe my exact words were, yeah, I'm gonna be in Chainsaw Man, baby.
Very cool.
Cut to some stranger in the parking lot being like, what?
You didn't hear that.
And then Sarah, how about yourself?
Right after a session with Mike, he took me into one of the really small, not counselor, what do you call
it's
it?
It's like a meeting room.
A meeting room. And at first I was like, am I in trouble? Elevator, and I was by myself, I was like running around in circles just screaming.
It's all very cool. I mean, this show is obviously incredibly anticipated, so, you know, I can only imagine the feelings everybody had when they got that call. So, and then
it still doesn't feel real.
No,
still.
I'm not here right now.
We are hallucinating, all of you.
It's been a whole fever dream.
And then, Mike, actually a question for you then. What did you look for when casting each character?
I listened for voices that I thought suited the characters very well, that captured the essence of the character, and that also sounded really well together as an ensemble. Because, you know, yes, you need to cast individually, but everyone needs to sound like a group and have individual persona, and when they're speaking off screen, like, oh, that's Power, she's about to enter the room, all these sorts of things. And I thought that these actors here did a phenomenal job. And,
about it. And obviously, you know, Chainsaw Man is about family. So, you know, having that ensemble cast, as you mentioned, is
family's a thing.
Yeah. All right, moving on to my next question. First for Ryan. What drew you to the character when you auditioned?
My already deep love for this character and this story. I genuinely did not think I would get to audition for this. I thought I was too emotionally close to it. I never thought it would be a real possibility. And when I got the sides, I literally was like, oh, I know what page this is from. Like, that's how I knew exactly what to do. And I still didn't think it was gonna really happen. But getting to even play Denji for 5 minutes was like a dream come true. And yeah, I just felt like I knew him. And I love him, so.
And even with that, like, I was like, oh, he's familiar with it. I didn't know that he was, like, this familiar. I was like, oh, he knows what he's being said. That's me.
Very nice. Susie?
Yeah, I was the same as Ryan. I was like, I didn't even know I would have the opportunity to do this. But I had seen Makima around on the Twitters. So I knew that she was very prevalent. I was like, who is this? She's so mysterious and enigmatic. So I was very fascinated and drawn to her charm and mystery. So yeah, I was approaching that.
Reagan?
I've always been drawn to characters who have that kind of quiet, internal passion. Like, they don't always show it, they're not particularly expressive all the time, but you can tell there's a lot going on under the surface. And Aki really, I think, is that. I think he's a very caring person, even if sometimes he's very unkind. He never does it because he doesn't care.
Yeah. And Susie, how about yourself? Or Sarah?
I was like, am I not allowed to go this time?
Okay.
I guess. I also, just like Susie here, I saw Power a lot on the internet. I'm like, I don't know who she is, but her design was pretty cool. And I also did my little research, and she seemed like a degenerate, and I'm into that. And her energy is very, like, fireball. I'm like, I really am drawn to characters who have, like, a lot of that, like, gremlin kind of feel to it.
As soon as I saw her, I was like, this is exactly Sarah. Thanks.
And just out of curiosity, so who has read the manga out of this group? So obvious. Okay.
Not completely.
Not.
No.
Getting there.
Soon.
Yeah, soon.
All right, and then moving on to my next question then. How would you like to see your character grow over the course of the series, starting in with Ryan?
I would love to see Denji get more than just plain bread.
Plus nutrition. We just have his, you know, like, ultimate bread, right? So.
Yes, exactly. The ultra bread, that's true. Maybe to get him to learn how to use jam properly.
Would you ever eat that bread yourself?
Oh, I have before, are you kidding me? I've lived off toast many a time.
I feel like Makima's already got her stuff figured out pretty much, but yeah, I don't know. I hope they become good friends. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sure they will.
I hear the cackling up.
You know?
I would like to see Aki find a little more joy in his life. I think he's somebody who is very, he really appreciates the sanctity of life, but I feel like he can learn to enjoy life a little bit more for himself.
Give the man a balloon or something.
He needs a hug.
He needs several hugs.
Take him to the state fair.
Yeah. I'm having a ride.
And Sarah?
I want to see all the characters become more close too. I want to see maybe Power starts to like humans a little at some point. I don't know. Yeah. Maybe more cats.
There you go.
Always more cats. Mm.
Looking forward to meow.
Yeah.
And for Mike, how would you like to see the four main characters grow over the course of the series?
I think when you're introduced to the characters initially, you get like, you know, this is who they are in the story. Like, this is their place in the broad strokes of the storyline. I would like to see those lines fill out more, where they all sort of interconnect, and it's not necessarily, you know, this is the pawn, this is the knight, this is the rook, and the chessboard, that they all kind of interplay more and more and become more and more, you know, reliant on each other and things of that nature.
Very cool.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you all very much for answering my questions.
Yeah.
Really much appreciate it. And before we go on to the premiere, we do have just a few things to go over. First, of course, there are some special figures in the Crunchyroll store.
Yes!
That Pochita is one-to-one. So if you actually want to live out your dreams of having a Pochita in your life, you can. And then there's also that really sweet Shibuya Scramble figure and the Power figure as well. So make sure to go to the Crunchyroll store and check that out.
Can the Pochita cut down trees?
You can try. I wouldn't recommend it, but you can try.
You can saw it manually, just put it up again.
Given enough time.
You just gotta try, right? Alright, and then this is actually a very, very special message that we have from the director himself, Ryu Nakayama-san, gave a special message for all of us today.